we are at Bangalore's most favorite dosa destination. Practically, it is not only the dosa destination, but I call it dosa destination because the dosas here are something out of this world. Crispy, crunchy, full of flavors, full of butter, full of ghee, full of taste and full of life. MTR 1924, as the name suggests, it's established in 1924. And it's not only famous for dosas, there's so huge variety of snacks that you get here, the South Indian snacks. And they still serve in a very authentic way. And guess what, with me, I have a very Bangalorean who has grown up here, and this is her like almost like regular visit. I mean, I think almost all Bangaloreans do a regular visit to this place. So this is nothing new for them. But someone who is not from Bangalore, like for me, it is heaven, and I make sure that every time I come to Bangalore, I visit this place. So here is Pratibha, she's joining me. So Pratibha, come in.
Hi.
So Pratibha, what's special about this place?
Oh God, we prepare at home, but that taste is so different because this is somewhat prepared very authentically, the old taste that is there. So it's always a pleasure to come and taste this cold tasty. Not just dosas, everything South Indian, believe me.
So apart from dosas, see, I'm going to eat dosa. What is your favorite?
We all love dosas, right? Yeah, there are Mangalore buns are also awesome good here. Mm-hmm. And there are different varieties of dosas and idlis also we get. So I think it's always a surprise to order something new and try out what is good.
So let's go and order.
Okay, so after waiting for around 10 minutes?
15 minutes, yeah.
10-15 minutes, we got a place to sit inside this MTR 1924. But we actually did not feel bad because from nowhere it started raining. And that is the actual beauty of Bangalore. You know, it starts raining from nowhere. And it's a very, the climate over here is very pleasant. You know, when I used to stay there, it was still more pleasant. It was not as hot as it is today.
Now it's getting hotter and hotter.
So I have actually lived in Bangalore for quite a long time. My major part of my career, my IT career, I was actually in Bangalore. So I know most of the food giants here, and I'm very much familiar with the climate, the Bangalore climate, and especially the food. And that is what it gets.
Like, that's what pulling back. You back to Bangalore, right?
Yes. I come to Bangalore especially, I mean, I'm not joking, especially to have this khatte idli and this masala dosa, because no one in the world serves the way they serve here in Bangalore, trust me. And because I'm a big dosa lover, so Pratibha, what are you going to order?
Yes, we'll order one masala dosa for you.
Yes.
Then you can share my khatte idli.
Yes.
And one more rava masala dosa.
Yes, rava masala dosa is actually you know, the speciality of this place. And rava masala dosa is actually very difficult to make also. So eating rava masala dosa, you have to come here and it's really yummy. It's very crispy and it's actually quite a huge, you know. So one is actually sufficient, but we are over foodies, no? So we're gonna eat now, we're gonna order now, and after that we're gonna order Mysore buns.
Mangaluru
buns, sorry. That is her favorite.
Yeah.
So she every time she comes, she likes it. She is a Bangalorean, right? So Bangalore buns. So Bangalore buns she cannot miss on, and she's traveling to Mangalore also.
Yeah.
So this is the menu card, which is very simple. It doesn't have so many.
They have certain things only from 7 a.m. onwards.
Yes.
And then certain things from 3:30 p.m.
Yeah.
onwards, some only from 8:30 p.m. onwards. So they have segregated what time, what
exactly.
Snacks they can eat.
It's actually very well organized. And see, the simplicity of this itself tells, you know. But I tell you, this place is very, very, very pleasing. It's very cozy place. It's not very huge food giant, but they have maintained the old look. You know, there is one tree inside, you know, and that is not yet been cut. It still grows inside. So it shows that, you know, their love and respect, for the tree. Of course, you know, we all have to respect the environment, and we have to make sure that we stay clean. And Bangalore is all about, the whole world know how much Bangaloreans love the trees and how much they fight for the trees. And this is one example that they really stand by. You know, they just don't say that we love trees, they do it. The tree still literally goes inside this restaurant and it gets out of the roof. It's something, I think I'm going to show you that it has grown and it literally gets out of the roof of the building, and it is still standing tall. And there is actually another very huge tree outside that I saw.
Yeah, I know.
It's a huge tree. So that it shows how much, they need to protect the tree and the greenery and all that. So we have placed the order. So we are waiting for it.
I just placed the order when you were talking.
Yes, I know that. She's very smart that way. So in next 2 minutes, we'll come back with dosas. I think these dosas are nothing new for Bangaloreans. Everyone, at least once in a week, they come and eat here. So it is nothing new. But the people who are not from Bangalore, they can actually fly only for this dosa. It is that worth. It is worth, isn't it? It is worth flying from wherever you are to come and eat this dosa. Bangaloreans enjoy it, so you should enjoy it too. So we are going to eat Bangalore sandwiches. Bye-bye. Not bye-bye.
I think this is a quick to serve dish. See, look at this. Can you show how fluffy it is? Oh my god. And it is actually a huge idli, And there are some, I think there are some mutters inside. They've added some mutters.
Yes.
Some mutters. Just look at the crisp. Look at the how porous it is. It's very fluffy, see? It is so fluffy. And it is served with this chutney and sambar.
And
it's ghee, yes. They serve with the ghee, see? Oh my god.
I like this tiny little cup.
Yes. So Pratibha, why you eat idli? Because you are health conscious, is that the reason?
I eat what I love. It's not just health conscious, but it is a lot more in terms of less of oil, and it is steamed, so it's a lot more safe.
And the best part is they have actually added some veggies inside.
Masalas inside, yeah.
Yeah, see, there is some masalas inside.
Wow.
Can you taste for us and tell how it is? Yum.
With sambar, it's a little more nice because this is a potato flavor in the sambar.
Wow,
that's a different taste that we are getting. So it's nice.
Yeah, so
what I like best is this is not plain thatte idli, it's a masala thatte.
Masala thatte.
Thank you. No words coming out.
It is so soul filling, I tell you. So soul filling. Oh my god. These potatoes are not very highly flavored, okay? These are like, they don't have a very, you know, too much of masala into it. They're very light into the flavors.
Oh, mango buns, okay.
Very, very, very light into flavor. So you can just directly have it. As I said, I like to eat with chutney. And this is my favorite chutney. This green, as per the new fat, everything should have a healthy fat. And it should be in, it should have its own proportion. So the amount they serve is exactly how much is required. Just a spoon of healthy fat. And I tell you, I'm not able to control. I'm gonna take one more bite. This is the mango bun. Okay? So these are the mango bun. As you can see, oh my god. So the best part, the beauty of these mango buns is they're very crisp. I think these mango buns are fermented ones. These are not, they look like a level.
They have, I think, a banana in there.
Yeah, this is a fermented one. You know? There's so much of fluffiness inside of it. And this is served with a pure white chutney. You can just.
And you love that chutney?
Yes. So, this is the white chutney. And super hot. Hot in the sense, hot by fried. It's not spicy wala hot. I'm just gonna try it.
See, yummy, right?
Heaven.
Oh.
It's heaven. And you know the best part, it is served with some hot sort of sauce, you can say. This is what is this, Pratibha? Spicy. Mm. Oh my god. See, I can just show you, you know, how fluffy it is. So fluffy. And then I'm gonna eat one more. And I like to eat it. I'm drooling. I'm drooling.
You're like dancing with the food.
It's so tasty. I think,
gorgeous.
It is such a gorgeous dish, and it is my favorite dish, to be honest, you know, the favorite dish on earth. Literally drooling. So you guys should know why I love Bangalore so much. Because no one serves the dosa the way Bangalore serves. And you know, instead of it, actually there is kodi chutney. You know, you can see there is kodi chutney, but add one more flavor to it.
It and looks crispy also, right?
Yes, and I'm going to actually enjoy this with green chutney. We'll have one coffee. Yeah, one coffee. Okay, very strong. Strong. So, this is a very spicy chutney.
Look at your face.
I think, you know, people who love food, they should actually feel it. And there's no feeling, you know, feel of being crispy. Look at it, so I mean, you know, it is something like, there's nothing as obvious.
That's nice.
This is nothing as gorgeous, as tasty as this rabbit, you know? Guys, to be honest, my only love in this world is food. I love only food, nobody else. What's my daughter?
My food is food.
So I'm gonna enjoy. And you know, Pratibha, when she comes here, she just enjoys bun because she's a bunny, you know. She loves to eat fluffy, light stuff, and I'm exactly at I'm going to get myself drooled in this dish. So coffee next time.